Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to more Life is Strange. In the previous video, we got some warm feels here in the hospital, which is not a common thing because, personally speaking, hospitals give me the heebie-jeebies, but we were able to get some good warm feels with Kate, so all that is good, and I know somebody's going to be phrasing at that for some reason, but no, this is all pure stuffs. Pure goodness. Anyways, let's go and continue our investigation.
Well, how is she?
She's still Kate Marsh. Thank God.
I'm glad we came to see her.
Thanks for coming with me.
Now let's go pay a visit to Nathan Prescott.
I agree.
That little prick is not going to be glad when he sees us.
And we're off! I see those two are having themselves a nice and wonderful conversation, I'm sure, about things that are all about education purposes. Feels like a while since we've had a nice establishing shot. So
hey,
yeah,
Max.
We got a few there. Thankfully, they were rather brief.
Hi, Mr. Jefferson. I'm okay. And this is my friend Chloe.
Yo.
Chloe? Why isn't somebody as cool as you going to Blackwell?
I was way too cool for this school. It's a long story. In actual files here.
I can imagine. Max, are you sure that you're all right?
It's weird just being on campus like everything's normal.
I know. Lame as it sounds, life has to go on.
I think there's too much going on in my life.
On that note, Blackwell duty calls. Remember, I'm going to announce the winner of the Everyday Heroes contest tonight at the party, so I hope you'll be there to celebrate, even though I'm sorry you didn't enter a photo. I understand your reasons. You can't force an artist to work.
I feel like you're a total loser, but it's been a hard week to focus. No pun intended.
I'm proud of you for taking
so much because
trouble,
camera.
Friend.
Ha, get it.
And I take hope in the fact that you have plenty of time to find your way.
I get it because I am SMRT.
Get in the habit of putting your work out there.
Thanks, Mr. Jefferson. I'll definitely be there tonight.
Me too. I'll be Max's date. You better dance with us at least once.
Nobody should have to see me dance. Plus, you don't want to watch the old hipster trying to keep up with the kids. I have some pride. Be seeing you.
Yes, you will.
You can't be older than 30. Come on.
Hot for teacher.
Gross! You're out of control.
Not yet. Just wait until the rager tonight.
Shut up.
Don't be jealous because Mark Jefferson thinks I'm cool.
I am so ignoring you.
Fine. Since I'm here, I'll see if I can get some dirt from Justin. I haven't talked to him in a while.
Now that is a great plan. Let's see if I can find out where Nathan is.
Alright, let's go dig up some dirty deets. Done dirt cheap. And all that snazzy jazzy stuff.
I had to clear away another batch of dead birds today.
That's so ironic.
Let's go talk with Brooke.
Hey Brooke, how are you?
I'm here as usual. By the way, thanks for helping Kate down. Are you okay?
Let's talk about the whales, because those are a weird thing happening.
I can't get my limited brain around that eclipse and the beached whales. I was hoping the science department had some ideas.
Warren and I are supposed to compare notes and theories this weekend.
That makes sense. Two big brains are better than one. Or mine.
We'd get the Nobel Prize if we could explain this phenomenon, but even Miss Grant has no clue.
I might feel better taking your drone for a quick flight.
Miss Grant finally gave up and let me fly her again. But you're going to the drive-in with Warren, so you don't have time to fly my drone.
Really? I can't fly your drone because I'm going to see ape movies with Warren?
You are perceptive, Max. Now, excuse me. My drone needs...
Somebody's feeling a little jello.
Time to go clean up graffiti.
Let's talk with Ms.
Hi,
Grant.
Ms. Grant.
Max, you always
sure, she
show
must know
up
something,
when I'm
talking
right? about you. I'm still bragging about you and the other students making Blackwell surveillance free.
I was looking for Nathan Prescott, and I thought he might be in your class.
Mr. Prescott has no class at all after his suspension. I didn't think you were friends.
Let's see. Let's go with, oh, hell nah.
Hell no. Sorry, Miss Grant.
You're an adult. You can swear, damn it. And I'm glad you did.
So you haven't seen Nathan at all?
Let's just say I try not to, Max. But I did catch him storming off
campus. Really?
After what happened this week, I hope you don't see
him. Well, that's
either.
All the information
You're
we need about him,
here,
I think.
You might be the wisest.
We could talk about other stuff, but
I'm sorry, Miss Green.
I think this there's a lot of things happening in this part.
I'll see you later.
It's always good talking to you, Max.
Good. Nathan is not around. I should go back to Chloe.
Also, how'd you guys like my Colonel Parker impersonation? Good? Bad? Not wrestling fans, so you have no idea who I'm talking about?
Justin, it's been so long since
I've
seen you.
See, those two are having a good time.
Way too cool for us now, Chloe.
Oh yeah, this guy's doing some scare tricks.
Try going to
cool.
Insane.
Coast is clear. It would be so cool if you and me were going to school here together.
But now you can have Mr. Jefferson all to yourself.
Ugh, you suck. Now let's get into Blackwell Ninja mode.
Yeah. NSP time, baby!
So lame they don't have co-ed dorms here.
Yes, because I want Nathan Prescott in the room next door.
Good point.
Best point, actually.
Wait here. Give me the signal if Nathan or anybody shows up.
I won't let you down, Batmax.
Na 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 doot 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 noot. Alright, Nate's room is... Oh, okay, just give us the thing. Let's see. Supermax, in case you still need Nate's room number is 111. Kate, you are awesome. Thank you. Love that you bring out the rebel in me. You already are a rebel, trust me. Always, and please be careful. Promise? Of course. I'll keep you posted. I know you will. Smiley. And emoji. Once again, there's all these we could read, but now is not the time for that stuff.
This can only be Nathan's room.
It is locked. I just like how the game doesn't even give you a choice. It's like, oh yeah, of course you're just gonna beat it down with a fire extinguisher. Well, that's not gonna run up the electricity bill or nothing.
Now I need to find Nathan's phone. Or anything with clues.
Let's see, something from Joyce. Max, now that David is not here, I need Chloe to step up and stop acting out so much. But that wouldn't happen if you and her were getting mixed up in illegal crap like breaking into Blackwell at night. I know what happens, so don't bother to feign or explain. I hoped you would get her back on the right track, but it looks like she's getting stuck again. You could be such a good influence on her, unless both of you want to play by it, but she can't keep blaming David now. I'm sorry, Joyce. Even I get into shenanigans, but I am trying to be a good influence on Chloe. Ah, no, Max. I've got that you're still teenage adults. By the way, I found a nest on the ground in the garage. Poor eggs and birds. Hope you weren't snooping around in there with Chloe. No. Which is why we're not going to respond, because we totally weren't doing that thing.
That is so Chloe. Oh my god.
Oh, that's
Chloe.
Totally not creepy.
Chloe.
Oh. Fuck. I guess we should have moved it back. Fuck. No, we're not gonna turn on MP3 player and just, you know, get all the attention towards us.
Nathan is way into this party. Oh, bastard. Now I remember why I hate you. And why Kate will get justice.
That she will.
Oh, man. Sean Prescott might be Nathan's real problem.
Nate, I know this has been a stressful week, and your mother and I hear talk if need be. Just make an appointment anytime. Your mother wants Dr. Bill to come out after his book tour, but for now, let's stick to your prescriptions. I need you calm and quiet while Pan Estates is being developed. I know being a Prescott is a burden, and I'll guide you into this room step by step, as did my father. It was hard for me when my dad opened my eyes to our destiny, but you'll thank me someday. Don't worry about Blackwell. This shithole town is going to get an enema along with a fresh brand. I want you to be ready to take over when the moment is right. Don't fuck it up, son. Your father. I have no words for that. Absolutely none. That's just horrendous.
Too bad Nathan isn't more like his sister. She sounds awesome. And far away.
Tudo bem from Brazil, little brother. It's been too long since I've heard from you, so please let me know what's going on in your exciting scholastic life at Blackwell. I brag to all my coworkers in the Peace Corps that my talented bro Nate got a full scholarship to one of the best art schools in the world. Even though I can't always check my mail or phone, please, 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 please send me some new photos of campus so I can live vicariously through your lens. I miss you and your pictures. And yes, Mother told me you've been in trouble and Father has been on your ass, but you have to either ignore him or stand up to him. You know I love Dad, Nate, but I'm also in a jungle halfway across the world because of him. He's a bully who inherited power, not wisdom, and the only way to win against one is to fight back. Don't let him change you into one just for the family, quote-unquote, legacy. End of lecture. You're at school, so I just want to make sure you feel at home. I can speak words. Back to the mangrove, sending out good thoughts. Better write back or I'll have a jaguar ship to your dorm. XOXOXO, Chris. Oh, is there more stuff?
Nathan, too bad. Yes, Nathan sure needs diet pills. This is strong stuff. Wow. Kiss ass much, Principal
Nathan,
Wells.
I'd like to apologize for the recent accusation. Your name and record speaks for itself. Sometimes students will use that to make their own name at Blackwell. I know your father was upset while I have assured him that you will never bring a weapon to school. I don't want you distracted from school, and I'm certain this matter will be settled by the end of the week. If you have any questions, you know I'm always available to talk. Yes, now we can examine these scratch marks.
What the hell are all those marks on the floor?
Well, only one thing to do now, right?
Let's find out what you're hiding.
Looks like a cellularized telephone.
Oh yes, little phone. You are mine now.
Let's move that back. So we're good
now
to go now, right?
I have Nathan's phone, so I can show it to Chloe. Well, before Nathan comes back.
Now let's rewind. Because I'm not leaving any evidence. There we go. I was never here. They can't prove nothing.
Damn, Max, you're finally back. I got worried. So, what did you find?
His room was clean and creepy. Check this out.
Boom, Nathan. We got you by the balls, fucker.
Oh, speak of the devil.
What are you doing in my dorm?
Well, it's not just your dorm, you
You're
jerk.
You're such a nosy bitch, Max.
Stop right there, Nathan.
Make me ho. Max, I got this. Get the fuck out of my face.
Oh!
You are so fucking dead!
Oh! Oh, that's satisfying. We have two options. We could let him beat the crap out of Nathan, or we could actually stop him. All right, this one's going to require a countdown, ladies and gentlemen. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Yeah, let's be the better person.
Come on.
Oh, my head. Why are y'all looking at me like that, huh? You and you, you're all dead.
Let's go, now.
Plus, my dad is on his way. You're all fucked. He owns you.
Even if Nathan definitely deserved a beating, we should try to be better than that. Remember, you're on enemy turf now, Max.
Indeed. So, let's go and do some more investigating, gain more clues.
Damn, that was intense. Warren, thank you so much.
For what?
For headbutting Nathan Prescott. That was awesome.
I don't know. I almost went crazy there. Like Nathan.
You're not anything like him.
Good to know. So where are you going? I better stick with you guys. Just in case you need me to get my Hulk on again. Or should I call the cops on Nathan?
No police. Not yet. So maybe you better...
Warren, me and Max have to do this on our own. No offense.
It's cool. Whatever I can do to help.
What you can do is find out anything you can about Nathan's father.
I'm on it. Between the snow and eclipse, I'm assuming the apocalypse is around the corner.
You have no idea.
Seriously. I'll call you later.
You better. I'm feeling pretty alpha now.
Yes, you are.
Man, that guy is so fucking in love with you.
I know.
He really did give a serious beatdown to Nathan.
It was a little scary to watch him do that.
Now let's make a date with Frank.
Will he even answer you?
Frank always answers when he wants money. Like I said, Frank wants to see me right now.
Let's not keep him waiting.
And we're off. Let's go see Frankity Frank Frank Frank. And hopefully not screw up.
Seeing those poor whales like that.
Me too. I just think of their families in the ocean out there looking for them.
I know this is serious, Sam, but I'm getting distracted by that LOL sticker on the mirror.
You'll actually shoot him? Chloe, do not count on my rewind. Seriously.
Obviously, I'm not counting on you. That's why I have a gun. And I might even save you someday.
About time.
I am so going to hit you. There's no way we could have guessed this is what would happen to us when we grew up.
I'm looking forward to the day.
That's definitely a big mood.
On a road trip to Portland.
Fuck yeah. You, me, and Rachel.
Absolutely. So let's play this cool, okay? Just talk to Frank so we can get that code for the book from him. That's all.
Got it. No dicking around.
Let's roll.
Alright, so time to go talk with everyone's favorite local drug dealer. In fact, he seems to be the only one in the entire town. Kind of gives him a monopoly on this business, which is kind of unfair, really. Kind of allows him to control the whole market. Alright, let's give a good knockety knock.
Oh, look. The Wonder Twins.
She's got a new nickname for us every day, it seems.
Yeah, we're bodyguards.
Wonder what it'll be tomorrow.
So let's get to business. Where's my fucking money?
I don't have the money. Yet.
Oh, really? Then why did you text me that you did?
Because I wanted to tell you in person.
Oh, I'm truly touched, Chloe. Now, why are you losers really here?
We just want to ask you some questions.
You have some serious lady balls.
Ah, so Stephanie McMahon didn't make up that word.
Jesus, okay. Okay. But I'm not getting you high.
Frank, we're not here to get high.
No, you don't look like the type. Not like Chloe here. So what are you Hardy boys
want? Oh, I forgot he called us that.
Just the names of some of your clients.
Oh, is that all? Oh, well, why didn't you just tell me? How about I just give you the keys to my RV while I'm at it?
Listen, Frank. I'm sorry to be such a nuisance, but this is important.
Yeah, everything's important these days. But I can tell you're not bullshitting me.
There's no time for that, Frank. I just need a little bit of information.
Yeah, well, it always starts with just a little. And Chloe here knows all about that, don't you?
Come on, Frank, this isn't about me now.
Yeah, right, okay. Both of you are giving me a headache. No deal.
Frank, we didn't come here to fight. This is so much bigger than us.
When you come in peace? After you aimed a fucking gun at me, and then pulled the trigger.
I was helping Chloe after you threatened to cut her, remember?
You know, you're lucky all I brought was a knife. Otherwise, you and your girlfriend wouldn't even be bothering me. You really think you're tough shit, girlie.
I didn't know what I was doing.
Dude, get off her ass. She was protecting me. You've got a knife and God knows what else. Are you really afraid of Max here?
I'm not afraid of anybody except my maker. And you little bitches think you can outsmart me? Why, because I'm trailer trash? You're Blackwell trash. And it's time to take you out.
Calm down, Frank. Let's just talk.
Don't you ever tell me what to do. Get it, bitch? Get it?
Step the fuck back now!
Well, things are starting to escalate.
Oh! You fucking killed my dog!
Oh my god!
Well, that happened. Yeah, I bet you guys weren't expecting that to happen, were you?
Oh no! Chloe.
I just shot a man and his dog. I killed Frank Bowers.
You saved my life, Chloe. It was self-defense for both of us.
Max? Frank is really dead.
I know, but we can't stop now. We have to find that code. Fast.
Before the cops come.
That's it. Let's get out of here.
Sorry, Frank. I'm sorry.
Jesus. Chloe actually killed Frank. She'll never forgive herself. Or forget this. And only I can change it.
Will I change this event? Or will I let Frank here stay dead? Find out next time! Yes, we're out of time! I know it's a bit of a grim way to end the video, but like, I told you guys in last video, things were gonna start really getting intense, and well, there you go! Right there! That's part one of Intensity Insanity right there, right in front of you! So if you can't handle this, oh, once again, these are still just getting started. Just getting started.